Okay, guys, welcome back. So, today, or this turn, I should say, I don't think we have too much to talk about here on the campaign map. Everything here is still exactly as it was, with us sieging down Cairo with the king's army. Over here in the east, or the east of Europe anyways, or west. No, west. We've gone west, not east. We've got the army of Edward of Oxford, who just took Angers, the angry place, and is coming down to Bordeaux. It'll take him a turn or two. Yes, it looks like it's two to get there, but we should be able to really just have him start sweeping away the French, which is what we want. I know that our original king, King William the Conqueror, was technically a subject of France, but I'm afraid there's a new king in town here, and he is decidedly English. Or Norman, however you want to say it. But anyways, France will regret having started this war, regardless of what justifications they may or may not have had to do so. Now, that leaves us with the army of the prince, Tostig, who is going to take the castle of Metz. Now, I did notice that the Milanese do have some decent forces down here, and the road network here is really good, so they could even reach Reims, I'm sure, in like a single turn if they wanted to, or perhaps even Paris, because it looks like there's a road here, and I imagine it's not too much further, if really at all further, to Paris as it is to Reims. We do have some extra forces in both cities, but to be honest, once Tostig takes Metz, he could easily just turn around and attack any Milanese force that tries to come and take our stuff. Paris and Reims in particular are quite precious considering how long it took for us to get them, and so we're not going to let them go very easily. Now, Antwerp did have a very small force besieging it, just like, I think it was four units, maybe. So I just had the generals and the extra spear militia, the ones that aren't getting free upkeep. I just had them sally out. There was nothing really to see. The cavalry surrounded them and killed them, and that was it. Now, they are actually marching towards the border that we share with Denmark, not because I'm expecting to actually, like, cross the border and start attacking them, but I want to set up watchtowers around here so that I can have a good view of any Danish armies that are coming in this direction. So I expect more will, in fact, come. On the diplomatic front, I believe, now I could be wrong about this, but I believe I mentioned at the end of the last episode that we got peace with Portugal, which is why their army got back on its ship, but I believe we were also at war with Spain. Well, we are not anymore, because I got a peace deal with them and trade rights and such as well. So right now, our only enemies are France, Milan, and Denmark. Unfortunately, our favor with the Pope is as low as ever. And I think that's all I really needed to share, so let's get on to the one battle for the turn here. We're going to have the prince take the castle. And yes, that should not be... Oh, we can have a knight attack. In that case, we shall. But anyway, this shouldn't take too long. Muster your courage, men. Okay, guys. Welcome to the battle. I think I forgot to mention on the campaign map that we are purely going for ladders this time. In fact, now that I think about it, I believe that's actually what I always used to do back in the day. Back when I played this game many, many years ago, I never really used siege towers. It was always in Rome 1 when I did this, but I completely forgot about that. So, yeah, I guess now I know. I mean, partially, yes, it is because the equipment is very flammable, but the ladders also reach the tower much, or walls, I should say, much faster. Because they can actually run while they're carrying the ladders. They're also not limited to just having, like, one or two guys, or four guys, I guess, crossing the walls at a time. They'll actually pile up the ladders, which is something they don't really do in Rome 1.
breach the walls with their ladders.
In Rome 1, it's very much like, everyone line up single file, just one at a time, no pushing. But you see, look at these guys here, you see how they're all just kind of piling onto the ladders, and that means they'll pile off the ladders too, once they get there. So they can kind of just get a bunch of guys up there at once, which is kind of what the siege towers do in Rome 1. The idea is that the guys bunch up at the top of the siege towers, and then they kind of all get let out at once. And that's not as big a deal in this game, because the infantry will already do that, because there's just guys right one after the other after the other after the other. So anyway, we've got ladders going up at various points along the wall. I actually left one of my ladders back here because I really just don't need it.
Filman.
Now, the Milanese are defending the walls with the two units of peasants that they have. The spear militia unit is, I believe, in the center. Yes, and actually, were they spear militia or were they town militia? I actually can't remember. So anyway, the goal here is to seize the walls from them. And then to pile through the gate and go kill any survivors, plus the spear militia unit that is in the... that is in the center of the settlement. I saw them lose a couple of guys. I wonder... Okay, well, whatever. Maybe it's because this tower was able to get a bead. Oh, I hear it's firing. All right. Hey guys, come over here. Can we take that tower away from them? If so, that would be grand.
The Lord is with us today. We've captured the enemy's walls.
Wait, what did, oh, we captured the gateway, not this tower.
Charge! Billman! Billman!
Alright, get over here and kill those guys. And I guess we'll have our infantry over here start... let's see, where should we have them go exactly?
Very much in our favor. If we remain true and steadfast, victory will be ours.
Well, I guess just start charging in by whatever side you think will get you there quicker. Then we'll have... at least two groups of longbowmen. Actually, we'll have... why don't we have them all just kind of pile in here? Unless it's too hard to get them to line up. All right, there we go. And let's see, we will also want the general in here, so why don't we get him over here? And there we go. Now, have all of the peasants been killed? Answer, no. But not from a lack of effort from our men on the walls.
Double time.
I'd say that these units on the walls can basically stay here. We've got plenty of units that will be able to charge in on their own. All right, let's get the general to kind of charge over here and see if we can get as many of these peasants killed before they get back to the center of the settlement as possible.
Billman.
You guys seem to be struggling to kill those peasants, by the way. Come on, General, get in there. Actually, you longbowmen. Stay back here. Let's have the, we'll have the, oh, longbowmen are going up the ladders. At least some of them are. That's kind of strange. All right, get in there and kill them. Nope, don't await my command. Get in there and kill them like I told you to. Here, we'll manually direct... what is happening here? Wait a minute, were these were the guys who were supposed to be... what are you guys doing? The gate is the only way that you have in, so why aren't you running towards the gate? Like, Where are you going? Like, holy crap, what the heck were they doing? Oh. Yeah, I guess I really wasn't paying attention to what the general was doing. And much to my annoyance, the general is just refusing to attack the peasants. Are there still peasants, like, on the wall here somewhere? Answer, yes. For some reason, my guys aren't killing them. Look, if you're not going to kill them, then just let them go, please. You're just wasting my time. Alright, General, actually, I know. I just told you to pass through them, but then I consider this your own fault for not attacking them when I told you to. Okay, please tell me my levy spearmen are actually coming back from their stupid... Like, seriously, what were they going to do? There's no entrance into the center or into the settlement from back here. So surely the only path they could have taken was to go through the gate.
The battle is very much in our favor. If we remain true and steadfast, victory will be ours.
Wait, longbowmen?
Longbow.
Oh, why are the longbowmen fighting them? Yeah, it looks like it was because there were still peasants on the walls. I guess they couldn't attack the guys who were already down here.
Only half the enemy force remains.
Okay, now you longbowmen go ahead and go forward. And you guys, I think, were originally going to line up over here, so get over there. General, why don't you charge forward here and get the much bigger group that is up here? See if we can get them all. Why are you awaiting my command? There's still parts of this unit still alive, so go make them not alive. Then again, technically they're routing, which means you're actually quote-unquote capturing them by stabbing them with your sword. Alright, now, yes, you can await my command because, well... There is actually nothing for you to do. You actually completed my command. Imagine that. Oh my gosh, why are they coming up the ladders? Also, why aren't these guys entering the settlement? Did I not tell them to go here? Okay. Okay. Just in here. Like... We have the gates. The gates are taken. So you guys should be able to just walk through. So where are you going? I mean, like, the general was able to make it through here. This levy spearman unit was able to walk through the gate. Why can't any of you just walk through the gate? Into the gate. Yes, precisely. Okay, they look like they're heading towards the gate now. I guess maybe telling them all to go at once was problematic for whatever reason. Alright, actually, General, we're going to have you line up. I guess we can't really have you line up properly, but we'll have you just go right over here. And basically, we're going to have the longbowmen open fire on the spear militia, and the General will just intercept them if they try and attack the longbowmen. Since our spearmen seem to be having a tough time... Getting into position. Right, are you guys just gonna walk back out of the settlement and go who knows where? No? Okay, you're staying here. Grand. Are you guys gonna go around? Oh, I grabbed the wrong levy spearman unit. All right, well, you guys just stay there, I guess. All right, so anyway, longbowmen, you may now fire. Oh, they were forming their skill thrum, which is actually a really bad idea to do when you're being shot. As we ourselves have seen in past battles. Also, I forgot to tell them to not use fire. Kill without mercy, gentlemen. Boy, it's a good thing this was a small battle for me to learn these lessons on. What if this had been, like, a really important, like, huge battle that was really difficult, and I had no way of, like, I needed those spearmen to be exactly in position on time, but they, like, never actually did it? Yes, defeat is a distinct possibility for you guys. Though they will get some more casualties than I would like due to the fact that they are spearmen. So now that the levy spearmen have shown up, we can have them take over the battle. Come on, intercept. Step forward and intercept them. Shaken. Good. We certainly want them to be shaken. It is awfully nice of them to not fight back.
The battle is very much in our favor. If we remain true and steadfast, victory will be ours.
Yeah, they're wavering. Oh, did the general come back? I think he did. All right. Well, leave again.
The enemy army flees the field.
On second thought, stick around. All right, you guys. Stop firing. We've got this. We've got this. Here, we'll even tell you to move just to make sure you don't do any more firing.
All of Christendom will be awed by the victory we have won here today.
I mean, it was probably a somewhat clear-cut victory. I say somewhat because, wait a minute. Did I lose a lot of billmen? I can't remember how many of them I had originally. Let's see, how many men did I lose? 134? That actually seems like quite a lot. They start off with 120 men. Hold on, where are the billmen? Where are the billmen? Holy smokes. That's where most of the casualties were. 90 of them right there, and so that's 104 out of 134. I mean, I know they don't have a lot of armor, but to be honest, the reason I sent them up the ladders first rather than these guys, the levy spearmen, even though they have more armor, is because, to be honest, I've kind of, I'm not really a fan of the billmen anymore. I mean, I thought they would actually be kind of more useful than they actually are. Maybe I should have suspected they wouldn't be as useful, considering like their upkeep cost and everything is the same as the levy spearmen. But I also did a couple of tests in like some custom battles, and they didn't perform particularly well, even under what I thought might be more ideal conditions for them. So I'm just going to kind of, I've basically decided I'm going to replace them with catapults, which is kind of what I've already done with Edward's army, the one that's heading over to Bordeaux. You'll notice the billmen have been kind of left behind, and he's using catapults instead. So that's kind of what's going to happen with these guys as well, and that's why I was like, well, if we're going to lose any casualties in these sorts of battles, it might as well be the billmen, since I'm keeping the levy spearmen, but not the billmen. All right, but anyways, that's it. Metz is now taken, so let's take this back to the campaign map. Okay. Like, that isn't a lot of money, but then the men aren't very, like, valuable either. They probably would pay that. I guess I don't care, really, if they get released. All right, fine. I guess it matters not, for they have perished.
By God's will, we have triumphed. God be praised.
Indeed we have.
Victory.
They actually are decently loyal, too. Then again, it's a castle. I think they get, like, higher loyalty just by default anyways. So let's just go ahead and we'll occupy that. Yeah, Milan does not like us. What mission was this? Oh, we had a mission to take that. I did not know that. Oh, and the enemy army routed. Oh, right. They didn't accept the ransom, so of course there's no troops left for them to run away somewhere else. All right, but anyway, Metz is taken, and I think that was all I had to show you guys for this turn, so I will bring you back once more as something of interest occurs. Okay, guys, welcome back. So, nothing is happening over by Cairo that you guys didn't already know about, so we're just going to kind of skip right over that and stay here in Europe. Now, the army of Prince Tostig actually has, after they took Metz, we retreated back to Reims so that he could collect his catapults, which he now has. Metz has a somewhat decent garrison now with the troops we left behind, plus a couple of units we trained up. I might train up a couple more depending on how things go. Because, of course, as you can see here, the Milanese actually have a sizable force. In fact, they were chasing the prince. He was standing literally right there, so I had him retreat back so that he could grab his catapults from Paris. And so now we're going to have him return to his position. I'm not sure if we're going to... I guess it depends on what the Milanese do. Whether we attack them or not. Because it does seem like they want a fight. Which, if they want a fight, I wouldn't mind them being the ones to attack me, because I could put up a pretty good defensive position with catapults and longbowmen with their stakes and the levy spearmen and their skill from formation. I think we could do some serious damage to them if that were to occur. But we need to see where they go or what they do next turn. Otherwise, we might have to be the ones chasing them. We did manage to put up some watchtowers here along the border, so we can see a bit into Danish territory, and I guess a bit into the territory of the Holy Roman Empire as well. I'm going to see if we can continue placing like watchtowers here just so that we can kind of keep an eye on this border a little better. Let's see. So now we are going to take Bordeaux this turn. We've got our ladders. We've got our catapults. We have our superior mercenary spearmen. So even like the armored sergeants. Oh, I can't actually see their stats. I believe their stats are basically comparable to the mercenary spearmen. So we're fighting on equal terms for a couple of their units, and our units are better than a couple of theirs. And with our catapults to weaken the walls a bit, and our ladders to get up on the walls nice and quickly and not capable of being burnt, we should be able to take it without a horrendous number of casualties. We do have a couple of spare mercenary spearmen units over here, though, so that we can replenish our casualties as long as they're not too severe. All right, so I actually believe that's it. Nothing new has really happened on the diplomatic front. I think I'm still at war with all the same people and still have trade rights and everything with the same people. So I think we can just get right into the battle here.
They'll wish they'd never been born, sire.
Yeah, there we go. 7 and 14. I believe that's exactly the same as the mercenary spearmen. All right, but let's get into the battle. Okay, guys, welcome to the battle. So, we've got our catapults out front here, and hopefully they'll be able to take out these towers somewhat swiftly. I'm actually not sure how good the catapults are against this particular type of stone tower, so I guess we're going to find out. While they're doing that, we've got ladders basically all around all around. Oh. Hmm. I guess they seem to already be doing pretty good damage. I can't actually see the percentage, though. All right, but anyway, what was I saying? We've got ladders ready to go up all along the wall here. Let's see, they've got some sergeant spearmen over here. They shouldn't be too much of an issue, especially since we've got, like, 3 units here to deal with them. What's a little more concerning is actually over... Well, not here, there's peasants. It's these guys here. There's armored sergeants here, and armored sergeants here. Which, remember, they're the basically the equivalent of our units here, so this is much more of a fair fight, especially since... Did I just see... Ah, the peasant crossbowmen are also over here. I was wondering why this unit seemed abnormally large, but no, it's because there's 2 units. Armored sergeants and spearmen. Crossbowmen, I mean. The armored sergeants are spearmen. But anyway, the catapults are going to try and take out as many of these towers. Oh dear. Sorry. We were aiming for the tower. We kind of overshot a bit. Oh, and I see we took out someone else's chimney over there too. Oh dear. That's my apologies. We'll repair that for sure once the battle is over. All right, but anyway, for now, the catapults are just going to be firing at the towers, so I think I will just bring you guys back once we start advancing to the walls. Okay, guys, welcome back once again to the battle. So the catapults were able to take out the gate and these 4 towers here, but not the 2 by the gate itself, which is a little unfortunate. But we should take less fire then as we come in, because we're actually sending 2 sergeant spearmen, mercenary spearmen units, right into the gate here. Hopefully take it before they can come out there and try and stop us. We have our longbowmen lining up here, because I'm going to have them target these guys here. Basically assist these 2 mercenary spearmen units who are charging here. And then we have these 2 units over here charging these sergeant spearmen, and they should take minimal fire, basically from that 1 tower.
Our soldiers have proved their worth today. The enemy's walls belong to us now. Our men have reached the walls.
Oh, I see. It would seem that it isn't enough. It isn't enough to just take the gateway. We need to actually go up the tower and take them there. The longbowmen seem to be firing quite wildly, to be honest.
Walls are no match for the valor and force of our arms.
Well, I guess some of them are. Some of them are firing directly, which is what we want. Please tell me you guys are going up the towers somewhat soon. All right. Yes, very good. All right, you guys can now, I guess, come on over here.
It's very much in our favor if we remain true and steadfast.
Now our guys are up here on the walls, so we don't want them to get shot by our own guys. All right, our sergeant spearmen have taken. Wait a minute. They're still firing at my guys. What the heck? We have totally seized this gate. Okay, you guys get in here. Did I not tell you guys to get over here? I'm pretty sure I did. Get a move on. What do you mean orders completed? You haven't done what I told you to do. Get over here. Right, these guys should be taking these guys out pretty easily. The sergeant spearmen have slightly worse stats, and they're facing 2 units, of course, so that's going to be a pain for them. Right, you guys attack over here now. Actually, you guys can just kind of come off the walls, I think. Forward, quickly. Move it. Move it. This mercenary spearman unit is actually getting pretty badly blooded. Okay, let's see. Let's get... See, I think I want two units of longbowmen to kind of line up right here like so. You guys, I guess, can just kind of sit off to the side there. And you guys can also just kind of sit off to the side there. Oh, more Sergeant Spearmen, eh? Okay, what have we got here? Lots and lots of cavalry. Oh, the catapults must have hit those guys over there. Okay, so we've mostly cleared out that side of the walls. No, not the longbowmen. The mercenary spearmen. Okay, they're routing. And they're moving away. So let's see if we can get this mercenary spearmen unit up onto the walls over there to attack these guys from the rear. Let's also get the general in here, or at least let's get him close. See, it's just like in Rome Total War, how the whole unit has to be exactly in the right place in order for them to get up onto the walls, but their pathfinding seems to be better to the point that they... Oh, come on, guys, don't make me a liar. Come on, move forward, get a move on. Get up there, get up there, get up there. You guys seem to be having a lot of trouble killing this unit. We're only fighting one unit. How much damage did I do to these towers? Okay, I did manage to almost take out this tower as well with the mercenaries. Alright, let's see. Can we target the general's bodyguard? Yes, we can.
Winning the battle. If we continue like this, we will smash the enemy.
Victory seems certain. Defeat seems certain. The heck, this unit is definitely better than theirs. Okay, can we grab a unit off the side here and maybe have them come down here?
The enemy are badly bloodied. They have lost half their men.
Alright, we should do some good damage to them, so now get over here. Oh, crap. There goes one of our spearmen units.
Very much in our favor if we remain true and steadfast.
There goes two of our spearmen units, actually. Okay, I guess they are actually going to hold successfully that bit of the wall. So you guys get off the walls. Retreat. Still not sure how they were able to do that, but I guess it is what it is. At least their cavalry are being nice and slaughtered. Okay, good. That tower is not firing anymore. What we'll do is we'll have these two armored sergeant units hold this flank in case they try and come this way. Which they may very well do. Okay, we've got our general's bodyguard out here. Alright, please tell me you guys finally managed to kill that sergeant spearman unit. You did. But dang, did you guys take an absurd amount of casualties. Alright, get off the wall. These guys had, what was it, 120 men to start, I think? They lost all that to a Sergeant Spearman unit. Which I thought their stats were like half that of the Mercenary Spearmen. Which those casualties don't seem to suggest that, so I'll have to check that later. I may have just miscalculated a tad there. Okay, who can fire on them? They can fire on them. They can also fire on them. They can also fire on them. They cannot. So you guys just stop firing. Because frankly, we're only going to be hitting our own guys at this point. General flees like the coward he is. Press onward and break the spirit of his army. All right, the enemy did not try and hold, or flank us, I mean. That's kind of annoying. I wonder if in future sieges I should focus more on destroying the towers and stuff all around the gate and pushing for the gate and just having ladders kind of act as distractions elsewhere, but the moment the gate and everything is taken, basically just abandoning the attack on the walls. But it seems like even if you have better units than they do, it doesn't seem to work out very well. And if the units are equal to your own, like they were over here, then they'll just win that fight. Ah, there we go. You see, if you make the fight unfair, you know, like shooting them at a distance, it works out so much better than when it was a fair fight. Oh, they still have four little crossbowmen there. I didn't notice them. Those Sergeant Spearmen over there are the most deadly, both in terms of stats, and I think they just have the largest unit, so that's why we're going to target them. Oh, but we can't with most of our units, because they have gotten out of range. There's a tiny unit of Sergeant Spearmen there, or Armored Sergeants, I should say. All right, let us move a little closer then. Especially since we seem to be shooting some of our... Oh, no, no, no. That was almost certainly those guys. Here, you guys, just finish them off. In fact, you guys actually stop where you are so that you don't block the shots. There we go. That's a little better. All right, you guys. Move forward. In fact, let's have you move, let's say there. That way we can have... Yeah, this unit has tons of ammo. So let's have them move right up here. Actually, how about right there? Then we have this unit here. Let's have you move right there. So you're about out of ammunition, and you're still managing to fire, so I guess we'll just leave you be for the moment. There's that one... That one guy is still firing. By the way, if you guys hear power tools running, there's a bit of construction going on. I'll try and cut it out as much as I can, but I do apologize in advance if it is quite loud, and I'm unable to get rid of it.
We are the order.
Okay, what the heck? Why are my guys losing so badly to some mounted sergeants? Come on, slaughter them already. You're way better than they are. You have a bonus versus cavalry. Kill, kill, kill. Instead of losing, like, 20 of your own guys. Also, I didn't know that these towers could fire. Which is why I'm having my longbowmen try and focus on that, on the general.
Our men are winning the battle. If we continue like
so that hopefully we can get them to stop firing. Well, actually, I think we're out of range now. But we're going to get within range, of course, when we charge forward. So we need him to die. Sometime today, please. Alright, let's see if we can get some fresh units in there, too, because that mercenary spearman unit has been kind of holding the enemy at bay basically all on their own for quite some time now. Okay, these longbowmen have all run out of ammo. Let's just kind of send them back. And let's have the general come forward. Hey, seriously, how have you guys not killed the general? He is one guy. Also, how did you just lose? Oh, right. There's still that one peasant crossbowman who's just dutifully firing. Hey, seriously, are you guys not going to kill him? I feel like you should have killed him by now. How many volleys of arrows does it take to kill one guy? You know what? Actually, you guys kind of come over here.
Our men are winning the battle. If we continue like this, we will smash the enemy.
All right, and attack in the side. And of course, these guys are now being shot. Because somehow they still have not managed to kill the general. Seriously, kill him. How many shots does it take? They've got armor piercing, long range. They've hit him I don't even know how many times at this point, but somehow they still have not killed him. And now they're out of ammo. Well, that makes perfect sense. Right, longbows, just get out of here. You're apparently not helping. Alright, you guys, charge in. Apparently we're just going to have to fight under this hail of arrows because you guys couldn't kill a single man. Oh, no, 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 no. General,
our men are winning the battle.
I don't want the general to charge by himself into those guys there. Thank you very much. All right, you guys, actually, come on over here. Or just continue charging forward. That's totally what I told you to do. You guys charge in over here. You guys get out of that formation and charge over here. General, get over here. You guys charge in and kill the general. I would say he should go down very easily, considering he's been shot with like 20 arrows.
My lord, our men are in command of the castle. Good tidings.
Finally.
General lies dead.
Honest to God.
Send the base cur to hell.
Of course, now we have the Sergeant Spearmen and these guys who are all keeping those towers firing at us. So let's just charge forward and see if we can do some damage here. Where did my general go? I would prefer he not be in the front. But frankly, I can't see him, so wherever he is where he is. All right, everyone charge in. Just getting shot.
That goes to only men of great virtue and valor.
Yeah, I'm gonna disagree with that. Holy freaking crap, look at all the men we lost. I mean, obviously they lost a lot more, but still, not nearly as much as I had thought, and frankly, the mercenary spearmen did not do as well as I thought either. Again, I don't know, like, over here, unless I'm really just wrong about the stats of the Sergeant Spearman unit, I don't know why it took them so long and so many casualties to take them out. These guys over here, to be fair, there was Armored Sergeants versus Mercenary Spearmen. So it was like a pretty comparable fight. I did think that throwing more units in and trying to like flank them would have helped. In fact, I'm not sure why this unit here lost to these Sergeant Spearmen, because again, I thought their stats were considerably better. But then again, that Mercenary Spearman unit had already done some fighting, had already lost at least some of their men, and I don't remember how many men the Sergeant Spearman had, so I don't know, maybe that was less of a fair fight than I thought it was. But yeah, I think in the future, I'm going to have to really focus on just using catapults to destroy the gate and the towers around it, and like just focusing there while just having maybe some distractions with ladders that then immediately go away once we've taken the gate for sure. So anyway, let's go ahead and take this back to the campaign map. All right, so let's just go ahead and occupy the place. Merciless Mauler. Is that for his own troops? Because I think it was his own troops that were mercilessly mauled. All right, anyway, we have some merging to do, some repairing to do, and some training to probably do as well, because we need to replace at least some of these casualties and probably some of these troops as well. Before we continue on, I mean. So, anyway, it looks like that is it for now, so I will bring you guys back as more of interest occurs.